Mohammad A Arafat, lecturer, School of Business, Independent University. Independent University, independent scholar. Mohammad A Arafat,
thank you. In the very beginning, I would like to thank Heritage Foundation and Mr. Wali Rahman for giving me this opportunity. I'll just restrict my the speech or opinion into the topic. The topic is basically the role of media in or into this Indo Bangladesh relationship. Well, what I understand.
I think there are some areas where both the countries need to look into. The terrorism and the security is one of the very important issues that for our mutual benefit, for our mutual interest, we need to look into this. Then we have the water sharing issues. That's also very important because at the end of the day, it's water that contributes in the, you know, the production of food. And the food security is related with this matter. And here we have the business, trade and business. This is also for the mutual benefit of both the countries. But the thing is, both the countries need to understand that there are certain things, the issues that we need to come into a common agreement, or agreement for our common interest. And this is going to positively affect both the countries. Very important. The more we have this agreement, antagonistic kind of relationship, it's not good for either of the countries. So the thing is, but we have a different reality here in this country. Like Mr. Rashid mentioned in his paper, that between India and Pakistan, they have an antagonistic relationship. And we know that this kind of relationship don't do good to anyone. Then why do they have the domestic politics and the internal politics? For their individual interest and for the group interest, they sacrifice the bigger interest of the country and the interest of the region. Because it has religion, it has anti-Indian sentiment, it has history of riots and all those kind of stuff, and they capitalize on all this and try to, you know, win the heart of the people of this country who are not quite educated and conscious about the whole matter. That's where I think the media has a vital role to play, which is media don't have to take the side of anything. What the media can do, especially in Bangladesh, I think, you know, this particular issue doesn't matter much in the domestic politics in India, but it matters a lot in Bangladesh. It's a huge, big factor in the domestic politics. So what media can do is, can uphold all the truths, all the facts. This is what we lack the most. We interpret, misinterpret, we propagate, but we don't have the facts. Even the very recently, and this is what I have, it all came as a surprise to me. When I came to know, you know, this India-Bangladesh 25 years back and those kind of stuff, and it is like sell off the country, and then I investigated into it, and then I found out a completely different picture. How many people are going to do it? Going to investigate into it, dig into it, and spend the time and all that. So it's the role of the media, I think it's very strong in here, who can reach out to the people and uphold the facts and leave it on to the people of the country to apply their own judgment based on the facts. But as long as we're not, you know, familiar with the facts, we're not exposed to the facts, we hear all the propaganda and misinterpretation of whatever happens between India and Bangladesh, we're not in a position to actually decide or take the right stance in this particular issue. So I think this is very important here to educate the audience of the media through its news or talk shows or even the print media, or it can be the, you know, the internet media and all that. So this is very vital here. Let us try to educate the people first in Bangladesh. Those who their opinion matters. Mr. Sonjeshan Gupta said that we have to implement this communique as quick as possible. But what is there in the communique, most of the people don't know it. So whose responsibility is this? To educate the people about the communique. I hear people saying that we haven't addressed most of the important issues that matter to Bangladesh. But that's not all true. Why do people talk like this then? So what media is doing here? So I think the sole objective of the media regardless of its political belief or whatever, is have to, you know, vow that no matter what, we're going to uphold the facts, the objective facts, no interpretation, let people do it, interpret and, you know, apply the judgment. That's about it. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.